Our correspondent, Queenie Casimiro. Queenie.
Yes, Casey, one person died while at least six others were confirmed to have been wounded after they were ambushed in Panglima Estino, Sulu this morning. Chief Inspector Chris Conrad Gutierrez, spokesperson of the Sulu Provincial Police Office, said the group of voters were on their way to the polling center when they were fired upon. The Western Mindanao Command has identified the victims as supporters of mayoralty candidate Munib Estino. Meanwhile, here in Zamboanga City, at least nine polling precincts started voting without PICOS machines. These PICOS machines were discovered to be defective during the testing and sealing on Wednesday and Thursday. According to District 2 Election Officer Jesus Alvin Lim, they have already asked for replacement. However, until now, the replacements have not been shipped to the city. Right now, the Board of Election Inspectors are allowing the voters to cast their votes and place the ballots inside the ballot bin. The COMELEC is confident the sanctity of the ballots are still preserved since watchers are of the different political parties are present in these precincts. Meanwhile, election in most parts of Zamboanga City started promptly with minor or common problems like oversized ballots, which the COMELEC advised the BEIs to just trim so it would fit in the PICOS machines. At the Zamboanga City Reformatory Center, some 298 inmates are presently casting their votes. Their ballots will be hand-carried by the BEI to the nearest polling center. In Basilan, the PICOS machines and other election paraphernalia were dispatched to the municipalities of Albarca, Akbar, Haji Mutamad, and Tuburan just this morning due to security concerns. The testing and sealing of the PICOS were done last week in Lamitan City. Canvassing of the election returns will also be held in Lamitan. Since last month, at least three explosions occurred in Lamitan City, but the police and AFP were one in saying that there is still no election-related violent incident in the city. Back to you, Pinky.
All right, Queenie, you were talking about some PICOS machines that failed the final testing and sealing since last week, and they were promised that somehow these will be replaced, but it never got there. Do you know exactly where that is in Zamboanga?
There are at least nine villages, nine precincts that have this problem. Some are located in the islands, while some in far-flung villages. But the COMELEC has advised the BEIs to just accept and allow the voters to drop their ballots inside the ballot bin. So, and this will be canvassed later.
Right. It's the usual case. Some of it also happened this morning. They do what's intended for them to do, shade the ballots, and then instead of feeding it to the PICOS machines, what they actually really do, as you said, Queenie, is they drop it, because that's actually a box right after that PICOS machine. So there weren't any problems, though, with the voters that they had to do this and it was not fed automatically to the machine.
Piki, some voters expressed frustration over this situation, but then they are just counting on the word of the COMELEC and the BEIs that their votes will still be counted and their ballots will be protected, especially so they're depending on the presence of the political watchers of the
right.
different political groups
right.
who are present in the polling center.
There has to be okay. representatives from different parties so that they can trust the process, because really the question there is, if the COMELEC was not able to replace those PICOS machines since last week, knowing that they were defective, I wonder if these PICOS machines can actually be replaced now. So it's just two things. Either the PICOS machines will be replaced, or I guess they're going to have to count that manually. All right, Queenie, we'll get more updates from you a little later on. Thanks a lot. Queenie Casimiro.